I remember standing in the background of a crowded room after sharing my story at a women's conference, and it'll never escape me. How we locked eyes from a distance as though familiar had been found. It was all we could do, as the deafening roar of hundreds of voices in the room plummeted over the edge of every soundbite. She began to walk towards me with an urgency in her hesitant stride. I thought there'd been something contained in that brief glance, but couldn't be sure. She looked like a heavyweight champion. The way she carried those bags underneath her eyes like trophies, I could tell. She had been through wars unknown and still somehow made it out alive, bruised and battered. I couldn't have prepared myself for what was to come next. It was as if time froze in a capsule, begging for reconciliation. And there I stood, heavy, as she heaved her sorrow, arms anchored around me like a buoy of belief in the wake of hopelessness, a stream of pain drifting from her eyes as she whimpered words I could never forget, even if I tried. 30 years. My husband of 30 years has left, she said. And before I could even muster a failed attempt to dig through the wreckage layered on her shoulders and mosaic her shattered pieces, from weary lungs she unleashed, "But your words of the staying power of a true lover has kept me here, alive, and with hope that holds me. When I thought I was at the end of my rope, you saw me. You saw me. You would think it was almost as if I called her by name from that stage. Every analogy and synonym I spoke, she recollected and felt in her veins. It was living water to her comatose soul. It was the very encounter that resuscitated her bones. See, these are not coincidental moments. These are Elijah moments. These are Esther moments. These are Emmanuel moments. The practical and the prophetic, the hope and the healing, where defeat meets God's divine through the passage of you and I, to see the one with riddles of her mind left unsolved, to see the one whose heartbeat beckons to discover a roadmap to redemption. She's tried to rebuild. She longs to restore. But the unbelief thickens and muzzles her pulse. We have no strength to brush away the remnants of her ashes, no will to unveil her destruction, because no scheme, no plan, no man-made attempt can keep her heart from shattering. But I knew the one who could. The one who makes sanctuaries out of shattered pieces. And it'll never escape me how we locked eyes from a distance as though familiar had been found. It was his power within me that she was searching for. And it was his power within me that she finally found. I could see the justice of restoration, tangible in the form of tears, as she wiped her eyes of the misery and fixated them towards the Messiah. The God who sees once again, and in all of its weight and glory, he made me to be a carrier of her kairos, a messenger of her miraculous moments, a voice in her wilderness.